Today, students, we will discuss about Chapter 3, Types of Software. In previous video, we have studied about system software and its types. That is operating system, language processor, device drivers, and utilities. Now, today we will study about application softwares. Application softwares are of different types. Some comes in packages and some are customized softwares. So first of all, application software. So these softwares are also called end user programs because we are using it directly. Okay, so they are designed to help the computer user perform a certain type of work. Example, text manipulation. We can take example of MS Word. We can prepare document in it. But before that, we need to install operating system. Okay, if your operating system is there, then we can install any number of application softwares according to our requirement. Okay, like if we have to design, and it means we have to edit an image, we will use Photoshop or MS Paint. Okay, they are application softwares. If you have to prepare presentation, we will use PowerPoint, Impress, etc. So there are word processing softwares, and for tabulation of numbers we have spreadsheets. Got it? For preparing the document there are word processing softwares. Okay, some common examples are MS Word, then WordPad, Notepad, etc. And for spreadsheets we have used Excel, then in OpenOffice it is Calci. Okay, there are different types of spreadsheet softwares of different companies. Application software is not able to run without the system software. So just now I told that we need to install operating system so that we can install other softwares in it, like other application softwares that we are using for specific purpose. Okay, like if we have to listen the song, we will use VLC Media Player or Quick Player, etc. There are so many players. Now, general purpose application softwares. So now we will discuss about types of application softwares. So first type is general purpose application softwares. These softwares are known as packages. They comes in packages, like we can consider simple example of Microsoft Office. So in Microsoft Office, MS Word is there for documents, MS Excel for spreadsheets, MS PowerPoint for presentation, then Microsoft Picture Manager to edit the image, then Microsoft Publishing Software is also there to create brochures, magazines, etc. Okay, so it comes in package. So that is why it is known as general purpose application software. They are used by individual users and it suits their needs and requirement. Mostly people are using such softwares on their daily basis. So now we will study about the example of general purpose softwares. So first is word processing software. It is very popular category and most widely used word processing software mainly deals with text manipulation. Okay, we can edit, change text over here, we can format the text, which include composing, editing, formatting and printing of the text. Okay, we can prepare a nice document, we can format the text well, we can edit the text, etc., and then we can print the text. Now many advanced softwares are also there which allow the combination of graphics, images, sound, etc. with word processing. Okay, so these days we can insert pictures, animated pictures, sounds, etc. in word processing documents. So here this is example of my word processing software. It is Microsoft Word. It is the most widely used word processing software which runs on Windows operating system. Okay, Microsoft Word we can install on Windows operating system. Okay, so it is of Microsoft and the screen looks like this. Okay, this button is there to see the main menu. This is title bar. This is ribbon. This is second example of word processing software. It is also a word processing software which works on MS-DOS platform. MS-DOS platform. MS-DOS is CUI based. Okay. MS-DOS is an operating system of Microsoft and which it is CUI based. CUI based means command user interface. That means we can use this operating system by writing commands only. Okay. Icons and pictures are not there. Okay, so there we need to install WordPerfect to create documents. Now some elementary word processing softwares such as WordPad and Notepad come along with the Windows operating system. When we install Windows operating system, these two word processing softwares we use to get by default, WordPad and Notepad. Now the second type of package, general application software, is electronic spreadsheet. So spreadsheet generally refers to a table of values. Okay, there are some values arranged in a proper structured manner in rows and columns. The values may be linked to each other such that change in a value changes the other related values accordingly. You might have seen it earlier, if we create a table and if we find total of it, okay, like a single row, total of a single row, and if we are changing data of any of the row, automatically the sum of the row will change. Okay, so it happens that if the data is related and if we are changing anything, then automatically the data will be updated in the Excel sheet or any spreadsheet software. Computer programs that help in preparing data tables, calculations and manipulation of data are called spreadsheet application programs. Okay, so spreadsheet programs are actually computer program only, and it help us to create tables, it help us to make calculations and manipulations, means changing of the data. We can change and we can delete the data, are called spreadsheet application programs. Some examples are Lotus 1-2-3, MS Excel, WYSIWYG, OpenOffice Calci, etc. Many spreadsheet application programs generate charts and graphs from the data which are automatically rebuilt when the data changes. Okay, so once we have created the table, we can select the table and we can create chart of it. Okay, and whatever the changes we will make into the table, automatically the chart will be updated. Got it? So it allows us to create charts also, and these charts can be embedded in the same sheet or can be exported to other document. So these charts can be there in the same sheet or can be exported to any other document. Now presentation software. This software helps in designing and developing slides for displaying information. Okay, like here we can create slides, we can design those slides, we can develop the slides, and then we can display some information on it. The slides can contain text, animation effects, sound, video, images, etc. The presenter can record. If we want, we can record the presentation also. Okay, like here what I did, you can see I have created a presentation and then I am recording the video. Okay, so here the presenter can record and include his her own voice and set the time for each slide, thus making it more interesting. Okay, so presenter can record it and then voice can be included and time can be set for each slide, thus making it more interesting. So examples are MS PowerPoint, Apple Keynote, Corel Presentation, etc. And in OpenOffice, Impress is there. Okay, OpenOffice Impress. Now, database management system. A database is a collection of logically related data. A DBMS is a set of programs that helps to organize, store, modify, and maintain and retrieve information from a database. Now, what happens if the company, if there is a company, an organization is very large, then it becomes very difficult to store the data manually. So, the electronic software is there which allows us to store lots of data. Means it is actually allow us to store a large amount of data, and we can simply relate that data. Okay, we can logically relate the data. So a database is a set of program. It will be program that helps to organize, store, modify. Okay, so in DBMS we can organize the data in form of tables, then we can store it, means we can save it over there, we can modify, that means we can change whenever required, and then we can maintain it and retrieve information. We can even get information from the database. A database query language is used to retrieve information. Just now I told you that we can retrieve information. So there is one way. In database we have queries. Okay, it is a language. With the help of queries we can fetch data from the database. So then after fetching the data we can analyze, we can modify it, we can update the database according to the user's requirement. So one of the key function of DBMS is to enforce data security. Okay, so why DBMS is used? Because the data in DBMS will be secured. They have so many security features. Based on the role of user, we can also set role over here. That means if we want to show the specific amount of field from the table to a specific user, then we can set role to it. Okay, DBMS ensures that the user is given access to only the appropriate data. Okay, so here with the help of role we can decide that how much data we can show to a specific person. Okay, like if company owner is there, then he has the right to see all the data of the company. But if company employee is there, then he has the right to see only his record and the work that he is doing in the company. Okay, the company employee is not having rights to access all the data from the database. Got it? And this way we can set the role of user in databases. So the examples of databases are given: FoxPro, Access, Oracle, MySQL, RDBMS, etc. So we have studied different types of general purpose application softwares and its types. So in its type we have studied MS means word processing softwares, then spreadsheet softwares, then presentation softwares and database softwares. Okay, now we will study the second type of application software, that is specific purpose application software. So such softwares, as the name suggests, are designed to accomplish a specific task. Okay, so with the help of specific purpose application we can perform specific task. So the first example is accounting management software packages. Now you know very well accounting, that means the software can handle accounts. So here it helps in maintaining accounts and bookkeeping on computers. Okay, like you might have seen in various stores and companies there is an accountant who used to write accounts manually earlier, but nowadays it can be managed in computer also. There are some softwares that we use to maintain accounts. So they record financial transactions, okay, on daily basis or if whenever any there is any transaction, we can simply record it, any type of financial transaction, whether it is a debit or a credit. Okay, that means if we are purchasing something, that will also be written. If we are selling something, that will also be written. So then we can produce reports on it, like make the sale of the day or the sale of the month, etc., and can prepare a balance sheet of the finances. Got it? Then a balance sheet can be prepared. So it is basically a set of integrated programs like spreadsheet and word processor. So accounting management software will be actually integrated program, means combination of many softwares. Okay, so it is integrated program of spreadsheet, word processor, etc. They may also have modules for payroll. Okay, in accounting management only, payroll module will be there, inventory control module will be there, credit and debit statement, etc. will be there. Okay, payroll means to prepare the salary. So accountant is also responsible to maintain the salary of the employee. Okay, so modules of payroll will be there. Then inventory control will also be there. Inventory control means generating bills and all, generating inventories or invoices. Then debit credit means paying money to someone else, and debit means getting money from someone. Okay, so if we sell something, then in return we will get money, and that is debit. Credit means if we are purchasing something and we are giving money to someone else, so that is credit. So tally is very popular accounting management package. Okay, tally softwares are used by accountants these days to maintain account in a company. Now next type of specific purpose software, reservation system. You know very well, it helps us to reserve tickets, rooms and hotel. Okay, airline ticket, bus ticket, plane ticket, train tickets, etc. Okay, then rooms we can book in hotels and guest houses. Okay, packages, tour packages we can book. Okay, so it's like in for movie, we can book movie tickets. So it is very popular system which has made our traveling very comfortable is reservation system. So many websites like makemytrip.com, then yatra.com, etc. can make the reservations according to our convenience and budget. For mode of travel, train, bus, airplane, hotels, guest house and sightseeing arrangements, etc. Hey students, so only this much. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.